So in the last lecture, we have seen that every covering projection is a fibrillation. That is, every covering projection has a homotopy lifting property. Next. Definition. A map P from to B is said to have unique path lifting, if given a path omega and omega prime in E such that omega equal prime and omega 0 equal to omega prime 0, that is they start from same point, then omega equal to omega prime. So from we have seen that if clearly every covering projection has a unique path lifting property, right? Because we have seen that if P from X tilde to X is a covering projection and Y is connected, then and if F and G are maps from Y to X tilde, then such that they agree at one point, right? So then we have seen that they are F and G are marked from Y to X tilde such that P F that is G, that is their lifts of same map from Y to X. Then they will be actually equal, right? If they agree at one point. So if you we use that, then in case of Y we can take I, which is this interval 0, 1, which is connected. So Y is connected. So here this I also is connected. So we can take Y equal to I. And in place of F and G, we can take two paths, right? Omega and omega prime in X tilde, right? such that omega 0 equal to omega prime 0, right? That is, they agree at one point. So by using that result, what we have to have that this. So every covering projection has a unique path locus. Now we have following lemma. If a map has unique path lifting, then it has the unique lifting property for path connected spaces. The unique lifting property, for path connected spaces. So let us prove it. Assume that that P from E to B has unique path lifting, let Y be a path connected space and suppose that F comma G from Y to B are maps continuous maps such that their lifts of same map, that is this G composed F, and F, they agree at one point, right, of capital Y. Now we have to show that F equal to G, right? So meaning of the P has unique lifting property for Y means this, that if we have F and G from here to here with this property, then we have F equal to G. Now, so we will show that F and G will agree at each point of capital Y, right? So this is actually E. So let Y be a point in capital Y, we will show that F Y equal to G Y. And because because this capital Y is path connected, so there is a path from Y naught to Y, right? And omega be a path from Y naught to Y. In capital Y. So capital Y is path connected, so we can get such a path. Omega composed F and omega composed G are paths in E from Fy naught to Fy. Also, P composed F omega equal to P composed G omega, right? So thus F and so just a minute. So this F omega comma F is a path from Fy dot to Fy, and omega comma compose gum G is a path from Gy naught, which is same as Fy naught, to Gy. So this we have to so then these are paths in E such that this and compose comma applied over Y naught equal to right. They agree at one point. So these are two paths in E which are lifts of same path, this one, right? And they agree at the initial point. They start from same point, right? Hence, by path lifting, unique path lifting property, hence by using unique path lifting property of P, we have omega composed F equal to omega composed G, that is this implies F of Y equal to F of omega 1 equal to, but this, because of this, you have g of omega 1 equal to g of y, right? So we have chosen our y arbitrarily in capital Y, and we have showed that f y equal to g y. Hence, f equal to g. Next, we have following theorem. If vibration, has unique path lifting, if and only if, every fiber can only if every fiber has no non-trivial part. So we will probe this. So first assume that, so to recall, means a fibration is a map P from E to B is called fibration if it has a homotopy lifting property. So assume that P from E to B is a vibration, it is a vibration with unique path lifting property. Now we have to show that every fiber has no non-trivial path. Means if you choose any fiber P inverse B, then whatever path you choose, that will have to be constant path. That is, every fiber will have whatever path you choose in a given fiber, it will be a constant path. Let omega be a path in P inverse B. also assume that omega prime is a constant path in P inverse B such that omega 0 equal to omega prime 0. Now, what is our plan? Plan is to prove that omega is a constant path. So, since we have omega composed P equal to omega composed, omega composed P equal to omega prime composed P, because this is P inverse B, all these points, they will go to a single point B, right? So if we have any path here, right, then means all the points on the path, they will go to the single point, right? It means if you just apply P, then you are going to get a constant map, basically constant path, you can say. So omega composed P and omega prime composed P, they are constant paths, right, in B. So we have this. This P has a unique path lifting property. So omega equal to omega prime. By using a unique path lifting property of P, we conclude that omega equal to omega prime. Omega prime are constant path, hence omega also is a constant path. So let us prove conversely, assume that P from E to B is a vibration such that every fiber has no non-trivial path right. Let omega and omega prime be paths in E such that omega composed omega prime and omega 0 equal to omega prime 0. Right? So what is our objective? Our objective P is to prove that omega equal to omega prime. Right? We have taken two paths, omega and omega prime, in E, which are actually lifts of the same path. This in B, and we also have assumed that omega and omega prime, they start from same point. Now, for T belonging to I, define omega double prime T from I to E by omega double prime T applied over T prime equal to basically omega 1 minus 2 T prime to T when T prime is between 0 and half and omega prime 2T minus 2T prime minus 1 T when T prime is between half and 1. This is how we define omega double prime. So actually what it is, just see that suppose this is your omega, right, and this is your omega prime, right? So this is your starting point of both of them are same, you see this condition, right? And this is suppose omega t some point on this path, and this is omega prime t, right? So basically this path omega double prime t is actually this exactly this path. You start from here, you go like this, right, and then you come like this. Okay, so this is path. It starts from here and it ends here. So how we have defined our first we have this let me just so this 0 and half, right, this we have marked so this 0 half we have marked it to 0 comma t, right? So this omega is means portion of omega has been taken from this, from here to here, that is from between points 0 and t, right? So how can you do this? So you just t prime goes to 2, so when you multiply 2 t prime, right, so when you consider this math, so t prime goes to 2 t prime will send this one your 0 half to 0 1, and then when you multiply by t, then it will send that to 0 t, so 2 t prime t, right? Now we want to define in the reverse direction, right? So basically you have to define t prime so t prime so your you will start from here, so basically t minus, so this is minus 2 t prime t, which is if you take common, then 1 minus 2 t prime t, and then you apply omega. So we will have t prime goes to omega 1 minus 2 t prime t, right? And similarly this one, right, so you define you take you take this half and 1, you take it to this 0 half, then you take it to 0 1, then you take it to 0 t. So how will you do that? You just first t prime goes to t prime minus half, then by this you multiply by 2, right, so you will have 2 t prime minus 1 then you multiply by t. So 2t t prime minus t, right? So 2t prime minus 1 into t. And here direction is same as direction of omega prime. Then now you apply omega prime. So omega prime will be covered from here to here. So we have already seen that actually such a map, right? If you could just consider, yeah, so just a minute. We will consider its projection in B, right? So omega double prime t is the path in E from omega t to omega prime t, and p compose omega double prime t, this is closed, is closed path, in B, why it is, just see that, P, when you apply P, so it starts from here, and ends here, so when you apply P, whatever path, so this path will start from omega compose P applied over T, but do you know this, that P compose omega equal to P compose omega prime from here. So if you apply this over T and this apply over T, they will be same. So these two points will go to same point. So you will have actually a closed path, right? That is a loop in B that is homotopic. That is homotopic relative to 0, 1 to the constant path at P omega T. So just see how it is. You see this portion, because of this, right? What will happen? You are going to have something like this. This is P omega T, which is same as P omega prime T. This is P omega zero, right? So in your B, right, you are going to have a path something like this. And then it comes back, right? So such a path is homotopic to constant path here. We have seen that H inverse, we have seen, that is homotopic to constant path, right, here. So this path, omega prime double prime T, when mapped by P, we'll get a path which is something like this. And this will be homotopic to constant path here. Because P is a vibration by homotopy lifting, by homotopy lifting property, property of P, there is, because we have already a map, right? The homotopy of paths from I cross I to B, we are going to have between P compose omega double prime t and p omega and constant path at p omega t. So between these and that constant path, we have a homotopy, right? And of course, and we have a So we have a homotopy. So by homotopy lifting property of P, there is a map F prime from I cross I to E such that this F prime T prime comma 0 equal to omega double prime T T prime, right? So this is the lift omega double prime T. And this is homotopy between this and the constant path is actually relative homotopy, right? So we are going to have this F prime with this property and that F prime maps this 0 cross I union I cross 1 union 1 cross I to the fiber P inverse omega P inverse E omega E. So basically this omega t double prime composed p, it is a loop, right? It just goes up to here, then it comes, sorry. So it goes, this is your p composed omega zero. So this goes up to here and it comes back. And this loop is homotopic to constant loop here. So homotopy that we are going to have is actually a relative homotopy. So what we had actually that if F is the homotopy between this, then what we are going to have is, so F this so F zero, right? T, if you we need to put some other place, maybe F zero S, maybe we put, right? Then equal to, this is equal to P omega T, right? Because this loop has starting and ending point same as this point. Okay, so this and for this is for every this equal to F 1 comma S, right? So this will be same as this for every S belonging R. Okay, and this F of T prime one, this one is of course the constant loop C, can say P omega T, right? So this is basically this is equal to this fixed point P omega to this T prime T. This is for every T prime belonging to I. So you just see from here what you have. Capital capital F, so this F applied over this so from here and here you can see it is 1 cross I. From this you can see it is also if you apply on this set F, if you apply on this set you will get this point. If you apply on this set 0 cross I, you will get again this point. Also if you apply F on this set, that is I cross 1, then you will get this point. It means what? It means that the F prime which is going to be a lift of F, right? So P composed F prime, we have to have F. It means that F prime, if you apply over this, then F prime applied over this will be in the fiber of P, this one, this point, right? Yeah. So from here it is clear that because F map this into single point, and we have this P comes. Sorry, this. It means that F prime applied over this must go to a fiber of this point. So that is what we have written. Because P inverse P omega T, right, has no non-trivial path. No non-trivial or non-constant paths, right? Has no non-constant paths. F prime maps, because F prime when you apply over these, right? then I mean basically this is what, this is homeomorphic to an interval, this is homeomorphic to an interval, this also is homeomorphic to an interval. So you are getting actually paths, right? So since, but these are, these paths are where, these paths are in the fiber of this point, at the over this point, right? But but we have already assumed that every fiber has no non-trivial paths or no non-constant paths. So it has no non-constant path. F prime maps this 0 I, 1 cross I, and cross 1 to a single point, single point hence. Can you just see that here this is what this, if you just see this is your 0 cross I, this is your yes, and this is your I cross 0, and no, not this one. So we are considering this 0 cross I, then 1 cross I, right? So that will be here, and then I cross 1. That is this one, right? So this whole this also itself is a path actually. So this path is marked into so if you apply F over this, so basically this one you can consider maybe gamma, right? So gamma is a path like this, right? And then when you apply F over F prime over this, then basically you are composing F prime. So basically this will be a path in the fiber over this, right? But in the fiber over this, there is no non-constant path. It means that we have to have this as constant path. Means every point here will have to go to a single point. Hence what you have F prime, so 0 0 is here because all the points here they will go to single point. Means if you consider 0 comma 0 which is here, and you consider 1 comma 0 which is here, then they will go to same point, right? But then what you have, therefore we have this omega double prime t because we have already seen that this F prime T prime 0 is nothing but omega T double prime T prime, right? So this is what? This is basically omega T double prime applied over 0. And this is omega T double prime applied over 1, right? So this, therefore this 0 equal to omega T double prime applied over 1. Okay. So starting and end point, right? What was this? So this was basically omega t, and this was omega prime t. And omega t equal to omega prime t. Right? This was omega t and this was omega prime t. So this equal to this means omega t equal to omega prime t. Right? Hence omega equal to omega prime. So t was an arbitrary point, right, in the interval 0, 1. So we have proved that omega t equal to omega prime t. So we have omega equal to omega prime. This completes the proof. This completes the proof. So we'll stop here.